Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to introduce the economic topic of government policies, specifically two types of price controls that the government may implement into the market, and those are price floors and price ceilings. With that said, let's get into it. So here we have a general supply and demand graph, which shows a market in equilibrium. If you're an economics student, this should look very familiar to you as it illustrates the fundamentals of supply and demand, with a downward sloping demand curve, an upward sloping supply curve, and a point of equilibrium where the two curves intersect. This point, where the quantity demanded and quantity supplied are equal, which we have denoted as Q star, and they are equal at an equilibrium price, which is P star. But suppose that for some reason the government doesn't like where the equilibrium price is and they want to change it. They have the means to freeze the price at an artificial level above or below the equilibrium price, or P star, in an attempt to achieve a more equitable outcome for target members of the market. Allow me to explain. So if the government believes that the equilibrium price is too low, it can impose something called a price floor. A price floor is a legal minimum that must be charged for a good. Now, in order for a price floor to be effective, or what economists call binding, the price floor must be higher than the equilibrium price. A real-life example of a price floor imposed by the government is when they impose a price floor on wheat. This increases the price or the wage that farmers get paid for producing wheat to ensure that they receive at least a certain amount of money so that the toil of farming wheat is worthwhile. But price floors lead to market inefficiencies. After all, the market is no longer in equilibrium. This will lead to something that economists call a deadweight loss, where both producers and consumers lose some of their surplus. This is depicted by the yellow triangle on screen. If you want a detailed video outlining deadweight loss, just let us know in the comments. Price floors lead to excess supply, also known as a surplus, unnecessarily high quality goods, and inefficient allocations to producers. In other words, oftentimes price floors end up being wasteful. On the other hand, if the government believes that the equilibrium price is too high, they can impose something called a price ceiling. Opposite to a price floor, a price ceiling is the maximum price that can be charged for a good. Once again, in order for a price ceiling to be effective, or what economists call binding, the price floor must be lower than the equilibrium price. A real-life example of a price ceiling is rent control. This is where the government limits what landlords can charge for rent or a rental increase in an attempt to make housing more affordable. However, similar to a price floor, a price ceiling also leaves the market in disequilibrium, creating yet another deadweight loss. Price ceilings lead to excess demand, also known as a shortage, wasted resources, black markets, and inefficient allocations to buyers. Now, you may recognize that price ceilings and price floors look just like the graphs for shortages and surpluses respectively. And that's because, well, in both cases, government price controls knock the market out of equilibrium, and therefore it exhibits the exact same conditions as if there was a shortage or a surplus from some other non-price related shock. If you want to see our video on shortages and surpluses, I'll put a link to it in the description of this video, and I'd highly recommend you check that video out. As I said earlier, if a video dedicated to deadweight loss or other market inefficiencies is something you're interested in, let us know. And as always, if you enjoyed the video and found it helpful, show us some love by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and of course, leave us a comment in the comments section below. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.